Good evening. Welcome to the members of the class of 2015, parents, guardians, family and friends, members of the Board of Education, fellow administrators, faculty, staff, to our 131st annual Wellsville High School graduation ceremony. No event is ever successful without thorough and painstaking planning and hours of behind-the-scenes work of many dedicated people. This graduation is no exception. To all those of who have prepared our students academically for this day, served as class advisors, carefully collected data, reviewed and certified each diploma, edited and prepared the program you hold in your hands, diverted traffic and closed the street, although I don't see the street closed, set this stage and manicured this venue, provided and manned the audio and video equipment, rehearsed and provided the music for this event, and prepared the refreshments for all of us at the conclusion of this ceremony. Please accept our deepest and most sincere thank you and appreciation for all your diligent and dependable labor to make this a memorable graduation ceremony. Everyone can sit. You don't need to stand. This is our opportunity to have our senior class president, Sarah Murphy, share some thoughts with you, the audience. Sarah Murphy, please come forward. Before Sarah begins, I do have a plaque for her. It identifies her as the senior class president this year.
Hello, and welcome to the graduation of the class of 2015. Mr. White, Ms. Mueller, Mr. Mosier, Board of Education members, school administration and faculty, parents and family members, thank you for all the time and effort you have put in to ensure educational success at Wellsville High School. As parents, faculty, and staff, you have seen us grow into the individuals we have become. You have seen us mature, develop, and prosper. You have seen us at our best and at our worst. At this point in our lives, it is time to embark on an adventure we have never been on before. It'll be full of ups and downs and full of discovery and self-realization. As a class, we were best known for losing out on things. Some were self-inflicted, and some were just plain bad luck. It began in middle school. Coming from the elementary school, we were most excited about the slushy machine and the ketchup dispenser that was similar to the ones in fast food establishments. We enjoyed 1 year of this privilege. The following year, it was taken away. No more slushies and ketchup dispensers, but instead, ketchup packets. As seventh graders with no slushies and with ketchup packets, the only thing we had left to look forward to in middle school was the eighth grade class trip. It was finally our turn, and we didn't get to go. The eighth grade trip tradition was over, starting with us. We got to enjoy the coveted homecoming floats for 1 year, before subsequently they were taken away for our sophomore year. I think I'm beginning to see a pattern here. Our senior year, we were supposed to enjoy the privilege of having the lion on our float. But again, this was taken away from us. Can there be anything else taken away from us? About 2 months ago, I arrived at school after New Visions to a sign on the senior lounge door. The senior lounge was closed. For every loss of privileges and traditions that seemed important at the time, there are many milestones and memories that will last a lifetime. The journey where we began losing out on privileges started when we started school in kindergarten. We continued our journey on up through Wellsville Elementary. We experienced their lock-in, which at this point in our lives was the coolest thing anyone had experienced. Everyone was so excited because the elementary school pool was open, and everyone was so excited to go swimming. This is one privilege we didn't miss out on. With middle school came jump day. It was a day where every group of girls decorated shirts or bought matching shirts. You had to pick out a partner and two other people to go around and do miscellaneous community service activities in the morning, and such as singing in the nursing home, painting flower pots, or painting each other. We moved on to high school where the ICS kids finally joined us and we became the class of 2015. From now on, that is how we would be known. We experienced a year first as freshmen. We realized that we weren't the oldest and coolest ones anymore. We were the underdogs. At homecoming, the combination of the lights, music, and awkward puberty hormones ensured that we would stay off to the side by ourselves. Our freshman year, we experienced the first football sectional title in years. The world seemed to be waiting for us to move forward. Our minds were full of promise, hope, and optimism. We watched as the years moved on. Sophomore year slowly began, and all of a sudden, it was the last day of sophomore year, and we were so happy that the infamous sophomore slump was over. Sophomore year seemed to drag on and on. We were no longer freshmen, and we were all too comfortable with high school. We couldn't get a job, we couldn't drive by ourselves, and we couldn't do anything, it seemed like. On to junior year. Time to get serious. Time to decide how exactly we wanted to live after high school and what we wanted to do. Fellow classmates began pursuing a career at our local Career and Technical Center in Belmont. They began their journey the first day they got on that BOCES bus. They began preparing for a career after high school. No matter the path you took, you ran into a lot of tests. ASVAB, ACT, SAT, U.S. History Regents, English Regents, Chemistry Regents, Trig Regents, you name the subject, there was probably a test for it. Lucky for us, the one thing we didn't get to miss out on was the Common Core English Regents exam. We experienced prom, where we were forever young. We attended countless grad parties, and we slowly realized that our friends were leaving, but we didn't really realize what that meant. Fast forward 3 months. We were the seniors. We had senioritis before classes even resumed. We watched our boys' basketball team bring home a sectional title. We led the student section for their games. It was our senior night. We were the ones crying. We were the ones being honored. And we were the ones who had to make the major decisions. We were the ones who got the lion. Wait, what? We were leading the student section. We were at the top, finally. We parked in the senior lot. We hung out in the senior lounge for 3/4 of the year. We went to New York City. We attempted a senior prank, and we did a senior day at Darien Lake, where we finally got to ride the Superman instead of just the emotional roller coaster we had been on all year. We attended our senior prom. We danced, we laughed, we took pictures, and we had fun. We were the seniors, and now with every great story comes a sudden climax. We are graduating. We are here today to receive the diploma we were all working for, the symbol of all of our accomplishments. This diploma and the memories from the previous years are something they can never take away from us. High school is over, class of 2015, but we are only just beginning. Some of us will continue on to college, pursue degrees. Others will continue on to start a career in the workforce. Others are joining the armed services. I can't wait to see where we all end up, where we all find our success. Thank you for the memories, and here's to many more to come.
Presenting this evening's commencement address is Samantha Van Etten. Samantha was a valedictorian of the class of 2012. Samantha has just completed her third year of study at the University of Buffalo, majoring in pharmacology and toxicology. Please welcome Samantha Van Etten.
Good evening. It is my pleasure to be standing before you all today. I remember standing here just 3 years ago, but yet it feels like that was just yesterday. One thing that I have learned since walking across this stage is that time does not stand still. So graduating seniors, please remember, take each moment and enjoy it, because before you know, several years have passed and you'll be looking back to this very day. The journey from here on out for each and every one of you will be very different. The path you choose to take will be affected by many obstacles, but none that are too tough to overcome. Take each new obstacle that you encounter as a challenge that you will overcome. During my past 3 years of college, I have learned that sometimes failure is inevitable, but failure is not meant to bring you down. It is a part of life that can build you up and make you stronger than before. Don't be afraid of failure. Embrace it and use it to your advantage. Since I graduated, life has taken me on an unforgettable journey. I have lost loved ones, made lasting friendships, and overcome obstacles I never anticipated having. Each of these has shaped me into the person that I am today, and I am grateful for it all. Even when times seem rough, or you feel like there are no clear skies in sight, always look for the positives in life. Things may not always work out as you have planned, but they will still work out in one way or another. Take pride in everything that you do, with your head held high and your heart wide open, because you never truly know what lies behind each and every door that you encounter. Regardless of where life may take you or where you take life, always remember to enjoy it and do what makes you happy. Congratulations, class of 2015. I wish you all the best of luck in your future endeavors, whether they be headed towards furthering your education, entering the workforce, or joining the military. And now I will close with a throwback to our childhood, a quote from Dr. Seuss. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You are on your own, and you know what you know. You are the one who will decide where to go.
Now is our opportunity to hear from Jordan Pearson. Jordan is a salutatorian of this year's class. She is the daughter of Gary and Jody Pearson. Jordan has earned this prestigious designation by accumulating a high school average of 98.65. Jordan's list of accomplishments include the University of Rochester Bosch and Lomb Science Award, the Dwayne Anderson Science Award, the President's Award of Educational Excellence, Business First 2015 All-Western New York Academic Team nominee, and Clarkson University Leadership Award nominee. Jordan has been active in the Leos Club, Science Club, and the Yearbook. She is a two-year member of the Wellsville chapter of the National Honor Society, a significant member of the girls' basketball team and soccer team for 4 years. Jordan will be attending Houghton University this coming fall and plans to major in biology and pre-medicine. Please welcome our 2015 salutatorian, Jordan Pearson.
Good evening and congratulations to the Wellsville class of 2015. Ever since my parents realized there was a possibility that I would have to make one of these speeches today, they have been teasing me that I would do something in the final couple weeks of high school so that I wouldn't have to speak in front of everyone. Today, a part of me, with all of you staring at me, waiting to hear my insightful advice to my classmates, really wishes I would have listened to them. Because, as most of you probably already knew or could tell by now, public speaking has never been one of my favorite things to do. However, the more potent part of me is honored to be able to address these amazing people I've spent the past 4 years of my life with, and all of you in the audience who have played an important role in getting us here today. At first, I struggled in deciding what parting words I wanted to leave my classmates with. Then one day, I was driving around in my car and heard this on the radio. Chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. This summed up my feelings about today and the words I wanted to leave each of you with. Today, we are graduating from high school, ending one chapter in our lives and about to begin a new one. Today, we are becoming individuals, venturing out on our own unique paths, whatever they may be. We have become young adults, growing up to make our own choices and mistakes, each of us about to begin our own individual journeys. However, the one thing that will always tie us together is our time spent here at Wellsville. Although it may not have been perfect, as no high school is, we have all benefited in some shape or form from the years we spent here. Apart from the diplomas we are all about to receive, our high school experience here has given us so many more intangible gifts. Whether it be a best friend you'll keep for the rest of your life, a teacher, coach, or administrator that changed your life, or simply temporary people you needed to teach you the lessons you just couldn't understand at the time. Every single one of us can be grateful to this loving and supportive community that has given so much to us. There is something special to be said about growing up in such a small town, things other high school seniors will never have the opportunity to understand. Like having someone you don't even know stop you on the street to congratulate you on seeing your name in the paper, or the feeling of camaraderie in the packed gymnasium when Hornell comes to town. This is probably the last time all of us will ever be together again, a bleak thought after spending more than a decade growing and learning with one another. However, no matter where our path may lead, no matter what life may throw at us, we can all find comfort in the fact that even after overwhelming success or seemingly insurmountable failure, we can always find our way back home. Like many high school seniors, most of us cannot wait to graduate, to embark on these new adventures waiting for us. And although it may not be right now, or even in the foreseeable future, one day we will all be able to look back and realize how special it was to be a part of Wellsville. We are all about to begin this next chapter of our lives, a chapter we would not be ready for without the immeasurable lessons we learned throughout the past 12 years. The theme song of my favorite show, which I've heard more times than I'm willing to admit, says this: part of knowing where I'm going is knowing where I'm coming from. We are all here at our high school graduation, ready to begin this next chapter because of our time spent in Wellsville. And I'm eternally grateful to every family member, teacher, coach, administrator, and member of this community who played some part in making me the person I am today. So I would like to thank the Board of Education, the administration and faculty, all my teachers and coaches, my parents, family, and friends, and most importantly, my classmates sitting behind me. These past 4 years went by too fast, and I was privileged to be able to spend them with such diverse, unique, talented, and wonderful people. I'm so thankful for the moments and the knowledge that no matter where our dreams may take us, we'll always know the road that'll lead us home again. I wish you all the very best. Thank you.
Our senior vocal members have prepared a song for us this evening. Tonight they will be singing "Live Like We're Dying" by Chris Allen.
Good things, till it's gone. Never see a crash till it's head on. Why why we think we're right when we're dead wrong. You never know a good thing till it's gone. Looking at the hands of the time we've been given, if this is all we got, then we gotta start thinking. If every second counts on a clock, that's ticking. Gotta live like we're dying. We only got 86,400 seconds in a day to turn it all around or to throw it all away. Gotta tell them that we love them while we got a chance to say. Gotta live like we're dying.
The honor of Wellsville High School valedictorian goes to Scott Miles. Scott is the son of Dennis and Christy Miles and Cheryl Miles. Scott has a four-year scholastic average of 99.07. Scott's academic record has kept him at the top of his class throughout his high school career and opened doors to many academic opportunities. Some of his academic awards include the University of Rochester Humanities and Social Science Award, the President's Award for Educational Excellence, Business First 2015 All-Western New York Academic Team, the DAR Good Citizen Award, the Big 30 Academic Team Scholarship Nominee, the Big 30 Athletic Team Scholarship Winner, and the New York State Regents Award for Academic Excellence. Scott is a two-year member of the Wellsville Chapter of the National Honor Society. In addition to his academic accomplishments, Scott has been a vital member of the boys' soccer team and tennis team for 4 years. He has been involved in SAD, International Club, Leo's Club, Science Club, Ski Club, Usher's Club, and Student Council. Scott will be attending Damon College this fall, where he plans to major in pre-medicine. Please welcome our 2015 class valedictorian, Scott Miles.
Good evening, everyone. I am proud to introduce to you the Wellsville High School class of 2015. As I sat down to begin writing the speech, a million ideas circulated throughout my head on what to speak about. I kept asking myself, what can I say that everyone will connect to and remember for years to come? After twiddling my thumbs, tapping my pencil, and even putting on my graduation cap in hopes for some inspiration, it finally hit me. I knew what I would say to all of you. First, I would like to thank all of you for attending today and celebrating the conclusion to what has been a very memorable last 4 years and an even more unforgettable 18 years. My classmates and I would like to express our appreciation to the administration, all of our teachers throughout the years, and our parents for your endless support and encouragement to excel and achieve greatness. We would not be here today without you. I would also like to thank each member of the class of 2015. Not only are we classmates and peers, but most importantly, we are a family. Through thick and thin, we have been together through it all, and I wouldn't have asked for a better group of people to grow up with. Today is our day. Congratulations to you all. As part of tradition, I am encouraged to offer my classmates advice as we close the page on this chapter today, awaiting for a new one to begin. Let me begin with a poem called The Dash by Linda Ellis. I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend. He referred to the dates on the tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of birth and spoke the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For that dash represents all the time they had spent alive on earth. And not only those who love them know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard. Are there things you'd like to change? for you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to remember the way other people feel, and be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? In the words of Linda Ellis, it is not the date on which you were born or which you died that is important. What really matters is the dash, all of the years in between. Today represents a point on this dash, and all of the years leading to this point are but a small fraction of your dash. Our dash still has many years to grow. As we begin our next chapter in life, our dash will begin to fill up with new friends, new adventures, and new memories, while holding on to what we have already accomplished here in Wellsville. Before we all leave here today to tend to our busy schedules, I want each and every one of you to think of these next questions. How do you want to be remembered by others in the future? How do you want your dash to be represented? Do you want your dash to be represented by hard work and success in a career, a loving family that you helped create, or following your dreams and one day achieving them? It is up to you, and only you, on how your dash will be remembered. Set your goals on achieving greatness, and do not be afraid of failure, for if you never try, nothing will ever be achieved. Always remember, the sky is not the limit. It is only the beginning. The world is yours for the taking. Hold on to your dreams. Do not hesitate to follow them. I will leave you with a quote by Eleanor Roosevelt that I hope you will carry throughout your life. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Thank you again, and congratulations to the Wellsville High School class of 2015.
Scott, I waited for you to get seated because I need to call both you and Jordan back to the stage again. We need to, again, recognize and congratulate you for the positions you hold in our class as valedictorian and salutatorian. And we do have a plaque for each of you. So if you please come back to the stage, I'd like to present those to you now. Most of our honors and awards were acknowledged at our 26th annual Senior Scholarship Night on the evening of June 2nd. You'll find those listed in your programs. Once again, we'd like to say thank you to the people of this region and our community who contributed toward the total of $105,240 prior to this evening's event. Again, please, thank you very much, and congratulations to everyone. One award is traditionally presented on the evening of graduation or on the day of graduation. This award is reserved for the Stanford Mason Memorial Award. The family of former Wellsville Superintendent Dr. Stanford Mason was unable to attend this evening's ceremony, but have asked a family friend to present this award on their behalf. Please welcome to the stage at this time Katie Martell to present the Stanford Mason Memorial Award.
I'm the honorary Mason tonight. The whole family wishes they could be here, but they're celebrating the birth of a new grandbaby. It would be Stan's great-grandson and the first great-grandchild of the family, which is quite a milestone. And this evening is all about milestones. I'm here because 45 years ago, Stan Mason and Sylvia Mason moved across the street from Mickey and Dorothy Martell and raised two families as one. I don't have a family memory that doesn't include a Mason. I also received this scholarship at my graduation 16 years ago, and that's a milestone I'm incredibly proud of. Which brings us back to tonight. This is the 25th year for the Stanford Mason Memorial Scholarship. Stan, like we said, was a superintendent of Wellsville for many years, and he really loved his students. So tonight we remember him as we honor your big milestone. It's my pleasure to present Ashley Dressig as the 25th recipient of the Stanford Mason Memorial Scholarship. Ashley, please come get your award.
Now it's time. Time to present our diplomas. Parents and friends, if you'd like to come forward and take some photos, there is room up front. We do have a photographer here this evening who's taking some professional photos, so you'll have the opportunity to see those as well. Board of Education President Alan Mosier, Superintendent Kim Mueller, it's with extreme pleasure that I now present to you the class of 2015, who have completed the requirements for graduation as established by the New York State Board of Regents and the Wellsville Board of Education. It's time to present the awards. Ms. Sinsky will read the names.
Austin James Allsworth. Heather Marie Anderson. Olivia Cora Barnes. Jesse James Beaton. Paige Elizabeth Bierman. Zachary Robert Brooks. Taylor Gabriel Brophy. Alex Stephen Burns. Seth Dean Carl. Samantha Starr Carlin. Joseph Nolan Carmona. Emily Eileen Case. Emily F. Cavagna. Roman A. Cavagna. Dakota M. Chafee. Riley Matthew Cole. Jacob Francis Cornelius. Candace Marie Corrigan. Jared E. Costello.
Nicholas James Cross. Rachel Ann Cruddendon. Liam C. Cunningham. Desiree Joanne Currier. Megan Mae Dixon. Ashley Marie Dressig. Vincent M. Irway. Richard Hart Ewell. Justin J. L. Fisher. Sean Hayden Flynn. Justin Matthew Foth. Ashley Michaela France. Jacob Leroy LaRue Franklin. Alexander Edward Gabler. Megan Elaine Goodrich. Bradley Austin Green. Killian Robert Groom. Devin James Haw. Anna Marie Haxton. Brandy Charlene Hurt. Samantha Chantel Holiday. Connor M. Inslee. Kiana Lillian Kalkbrenner. Hunter Hanner Kane. Casey Mary Kane. Zachary Allen Kale. Hunter Elon Kyle. Tony R. Kling. Kenneth Joe Knox. Stephanie Elaine Martin. Brandon Scott Masterson. Sarah Louise McKee. Morgan Lee McNeil. Haley Jordan Mercier. Alexis Danielle Merrick. Brittany Jo Mary. Haley A. Messenger. Colin James Myers. Scott Thomas Miles. Logan Reed Milligan. Dylan Ray Mitchell. Bailey Aaron Morris. Devin Michael Mosier. Sarah Ann Murphy. Sean Lundy Murphy. Ryan N. Newsom. Newman. Ryan N. Newman. Mackenzie Patricia Nolan. Victoria Kylene Noller. William John Parshall Jr. Jordan Elise Pearson. Jordan William Perham. Chelsea Renee Peterson. Nicholas Michael Raptus. Daniel Richard Riccio. Mitchell Campbell Riccio. Destiny Elise Rubio. Zachary Gage Sexton. Gavin James Shea. Dalton Jared Sheets. Stone Tyler Skeeter. Alyssa Ray Smith. Deborah Eileen Stadelman. Noah Tyler Stevens. Brockton Marshall Stuck. Caleb Michael Van Skyver. Kevin Edward Walsh. Patrick M. Walsh. Ashley Sue Willits. Jordan William Wonderling. Cody J. Woodward.
Let's congratulate the class of 2015. In the back of your program, you will find the lyrics to our alma mater. Please join Mr. Hampton and our senior vocal group in singing our alma mater.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Sarah Murphy, would you please come back to the podium and as your final act as class president, help your class graduate.
Class of 2015, you can now move your tassel.
Thank you all for coming this evening. Please remain at your seats as our graduates exit this venue. When we're finished, when it's all done, we do have cake and punch on the lawn on the side. Thank you all for coming. Graduates, congratulations. It's now time for you to depart. So if we could begin.